guys, welcome back to my channel. Okay, so today I thought I'd do an art journal page. I've got some napkins and I thought I'd do as a, I've got this lovely London napkin here. It's got some lovely flowers on it. So I've got some bits and pieces. These are all bits of napkin that I used before, which are all in the same sort of colour palette. And I've got this lovely little bit of tissue paper here and some book pages and little bits. This is packaging, which I've actually just gessoed over the top, like this. So I'm going to use that as well. So I'm just going to do a quick background. So I'm just going to pop these to the side and just do a little bit of sticking down. I don't want to use that. I want to use some of these bits here. Not quite sure what I'm going to, where I'm going at all on this, but I'm just going to sort of like tear some of these pieces up and just do a little bit of a collage background and then gesso over the top just to get it going, just to give it a little bit of sort of texture and stuff on the back. So that's where I'm going to start. What I'll probably do, I'll fast forward it while I'm doing this bit, but I'm not going to fast forward the whole thing, so I'm going to try and sort of like talk through it as I go through. But all the sort of bits that take the longest, I will fast forward. So I'm going to get going. So I'm going to be using, this is the new Liquitex matte medium that I got, and it's a lot thinner than this one. This is the matte gel, and this is the fluid medium, so this is a quite thinner, but it's really good. So I'm going to be using that today. Also some gesso. I've got some of my oxides here, so I'm going to use a range of those in sort of the pinks as well here, so I'll be using those. And there we go, so I'm going to get on with it now. Just stick some of this down, cover up these dates because I don't really want those coming through really. Doesn't really matter what you put on the back because it's going to be covered up anyway. A little bit on this side. Fill this up with a new lot of gesso, which is the Winsor & Newton gesso. So this seems a little bit thinner than the other one I was using. I can't remember what the other one I was using was now. I've had it for ages. I'm just going to cover these up just a little bit so that I can ink over the top and the nice colour comes through. True colour of the oxides. It gives it a nice sort of texture using a sort of like one of these like palette knives, spatula thingy majigs. Look at the mess I make. Okay, so I'm just going to quickly zap that again and let that dry for a minute. Okay, so that's pretty much dry. That gesso seems to take ages to dry, so we're nearly there. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to pop some of this napkin on. So which way should we have it? In this corner? Or maybe this corner? I'm going for this corner. I'm just going to sort of just tear around it. Like so. Get this little thing of flowers here as well. Okay, so that goes like that. So let's just take that layer off. Pop that down like that, I think. So let's get the matte medium out again. Gel medium, I mean, stick it down. Make sure it's all stuck down properly. If I blop it like this, it stops it from ripping, because obviously the napkins are quite delicate. So there we go, I think that's pretty much stuck down. Okay, so now what shall we use? We'll use a little bit of this, maybe up in this corner. Actually do it along the top here. Okay. Oops. Go. What else can I stick down? Have a little bit of tissue paper on here. A little bit over here, I think. Oops. I'm sticking to my finger. Okay, so what else do I have? I've also got this lovely one here. I don't want to put too much on it though. Let's have a look where this one can go. Try and tear out this flower. I'm doing a very good job of it. Oops. Can go right there. Perfect. Looks very collagey, doesn't it? Right, I'm just going to give this a quick blast. Okay, so I think that's pretty dry now. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to add a little bit of colour. Oops. gesso everywhere. So let's have a little bit of this. This is the pickled raspberry. So I don't want it too pink. A little bit of that, and then I'm going to add a little bit of the abandoned coral in there as well. So let's see what these come out like. A little bit of water on there. Nice bit of pink. In there. A very pinky colour today. Very pinky and pretty, isn't it, today? And a little bit more of this, I think. Go down here. Okay, quick blast again. Oopsie daisy, I don't know what that was. I'm just going to add a little bit more gesso on top of this. Just a little bit. Just to sort of tone this down. Oopsie daisy. There we go. It's dry, I think, a little bit. So let's add a little bit more things over the top. Let's wash my brush. I'm going to use this stamp here. Another one on here. Let's use this one here. Okay. Lovely. Okay, so now I think I've got my little round stencil that I've made. I might do some like little bubbly things. So let's take these two colours. I'm going to do the pickled raspberry and the seedless preserve. So I think I'll just use the little dauber. Bubbles. Random circles everywhere. It gives it a little bit of something else. So just rub in there. I do like these little circles. Just cut these out of my die cutting machine onto a piece of acetate. So I think they look really good. So I'm going to quickly dry them because they take a little while to dry when they're like this. I'm just going to blast it again. Perfect. I'm liking that. So I need to take a sort of maybe go around the edge with this. Just edge it a little bit. Thank you. Okay, I think I might do a few little splatters, but I've got some white watercolour here, just in a tube. See what that does, see if that works. Not quite sure whether it's going to be dark enough actually. No, it's not going to work. I need to get a more expensive one. I need to get a thicker one, I think. It gives a bit more colour. I've got some nice watercolours and they come out really well. The white in that one, but I haven't found a proper white pen. So let me just get my other pen here. So I've got this one, it's white, but that doesn't come out either. So if anybody's got any suggestions of any nice white pens that actually work, I would love to know. I'm just going to go around just the fine. Because I just can't find a good one that I like. So let's add a little bit of this darker colour. Oopsie daisy. This is a nice, this one is frayed burlap. So let's add a little bit of water to this. Nice colour coming out over top of the gesso. Like that. Right, I'm just going to go and get my other white watercolour. So I can give it a little bit of a splat. Okay, so I've got my white watercolours, which I've got these. So this is the white one, so I'm going to use a little bit of that because it's got a lot more pigment in it. So let's hope we can get some more splatters on this. Let's see if that will work a bit better. Oopsie daisy, not that much. That's a bit better. like it's snowing now. Nice mess everywhere. Right, let me just quickly dry that. Okay, so that's pretty dry. I've got some little blobs everywhere. So I might actually just do a little bit of, I can do those runny dribbly bits from the top, but in a bit of a darker colour. So I might just do it. Add a little bit of this to it. I think it's looking a little bit too pink. See that. A little bit darker, I think. Okay, so what should I do with my pen? Here it is now. So it's a little bit wet still, so I'm just going to go around some of this. Pick out the leaves. Let's get some gesso in there. Which I might actually just sort of like darken up this edge just a little bit. A little bit too pink. A little bit better. Right, I'm going to add a tiny bit of gesso. Okay, quite runny. It's very runny, this gesso. Very watery one. Okay, so I'm not sure about this one, but it's still practice, isn't it? So, more practice, the better I shall get. I must say, it's nice to play and make a little bit of a mess. Should I do with the lid? There we go. I wonder if this will... No, see, it doesn't splat this ink. I think I'll have to go for the black in my watercolour, which is... this is what I'm just going to use this, so I can just do a little bit of the black. Flat over the top. I think that might be a little bit better. Don't want it to be too dark. Too wet, I mean. Oh, that looks nice, doesn't it? Quite like that. It's a little bit different, isn't it? So there we go. I'm going to leave it there and see how we want to think of it when it's dry. All right, guys, thank you so much for joining me, and I will see you soon. Bye bye.